Dope.
All right. So we're going to be playing Baldur's Gate 3. I have never played a Baldur's Gate game, just to open up with that. But if you're watching later on YouTube, thanks for clicking. Press any key to continue. Activate cross save. Sure. Like, you never know.
Yeah, you don't want to make a multiplayer lobby.
Right. Multiplayer. Windows Defender, whatever. Okay. Friends only. Level any create. This music. Call him Leo. Let's just.
Leo.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Am I online on Steam? I think I am.
Yes.
Okay. So you should be able to find it.
Okay. Yeah.
Just didn't press your hand hard enough. No, I didn't press. Wait, didn't press my I hard enough. Like, letter I. It's okay.
Oh, dear. I've been called worse things. It's okay.
Yeah. Same.
So, yeah, basically, when you think about this game, think about Divinity. It is very much very similar.
Hmm.
You know, because the way Divinity works is pretty much D&D rules, but it's all kind of hidden underneath gameplay, essentially, whereas this kind of brings it more to the forefront was really the main difference.
Right, gotcha. Because the only other...
Literally roll a dice for things in front of your face.
Oh, okay. The only other semi-D&D experience I had a really long time ago was Neverwinter Nights.
Mm.
So, that's... Yeah. Probably my only history of these kind of games. Neverwinter Nights, like, a long time ago. And then I played a little bit of Divinity 2 off-stream with Kat, so that was it. That's
gotcha.
My only
exposure.
Yeah,
I mean, if you think of it more or less in the same way as Divinity, you'll be pretty much fine. You'll kind of get used to the D&D aspect of it.
Okay. Launch. Imagine
I'm going to warn you right now, the character creation has a genital selector, so maybe... You know, for the stream's sake, watch out for that.
Oh, you mean that? Well, I think, so the rule with Twitch is, if it's part of the game, officially part of the game, it's fine.
Okay.
But you cannot spend an extended amount of time on it, basically. Like, you can't be like,
yeah,
I'm gonna sit here for 12 minutes, like, I don't know, just making my dick look good. Can't do that. It's because it had the same in Cyberpunk. Like, Cyberpunk... hang on, this is a little cropped. Hold on, I just noticed something. Probably because it was in 1440p mode. It's alright, there we go. Hopefully it doesn't skip it. Anything I need to know about, like, what's happening in the cutscene?
Well, the creature you're looking at is called a Mind Flayer.
Okay, Mind Flayer is common to a lot of things, yeah.
Yeah, so basically in D&D terms, Mind Flayers are kind of like aliens, essentially.
Yeah.
That are powerful, like, psionic beings. They're like, you know, can speak in your mind kind of thing. And they turn you into other Mind Flayers by what you're seeing happening right now.
I thought it was going to be like an Animorphs thing where they go into the ear. But that was much worse. But this is good. Then I can have a better understanding of this, given I'm new.
Yeah, I'll be your D&D Pokedex, whatever you need.
There's no equivalent of a Pokedex in D&D. Who are you?
I mean,
tutorials.
I guess it would be like the monster manual in the player's handbook. That would be the equivalent.
Yeah. Eye worms, delicious, right? Okay, origin. Okay, let's read.
So the origin characters are all characters that already exist.
Yeah.
That you can kind of recruit into your party.
Yeah, I can see like primary stats, so that's what I can go by loosely.
Yeah, but what you probably want to do is make a custom character.
Where is that option? Custom.
It's up at the top.
Yeah, I see.
And then
edit appearance.
There's lots of things you consider, but more or less, just go with what sounds fun to you.
Where to next?
What was that?
Like, the classes are all very classic, sort of, as classic RPG as it gets, right? You know, like paladins who can cast holy spells and are very tanky and wear heavy armor, you know, just...
Let's hope the locals are friendly.
Hells, so be wary. This place is trapped.
What are these voices?
It's opened.
That's what... back there. Oh, that's fine. I mean, most of these are the same body type. Oh, okay. I see how they've done this. This is a heavenly singing, yeah. This is the thing that takes longest in any RPG game is this. And it's probably it's probably ultimately going to get covered up by armor.
Yeah, the face does, they do a good job of not really covering up your face. And it does have, like, the helmet hide thing, too, so.
You can do makeup. Okay, hair. Can't do body shape or anything like that, like. Can't make myself thick, can I?
Yeah, not really.
Yeah.
It's mainly just the body type thing that changes proportions of the body.
I was gonna make warrior, but then it's like, oh, it doesn't seem to be an option. Hair color dusty. I guess
you make a dwarf. That's kind of the body type you're looking for, like a halfling.
Where is the body maturity. Older, that's better. Freckle intensity, vitiligo. Genitals, I'll stick to default. It's just...
yeah. It's probably for the best.
Probably for the best. Piercing style. None. Eyes. Graying. But then it randomized appearance, and we don't want that. Yeah, I mean, I don't want to, like, spend ages on the screen, but I'm not seeing, like, option to make a dwarf. Guess I passed it a couple times. Because it just starts with body type, and you just got 1, 2, 3, 4, that's it. And then it's just base stuff. Proceed, maybe? Oh no, there you go. High elf. But... how can I change that? I've chosen high elf. Where did I pick it? Origin...
in the, sub-race.
Race. Oh, there. Okay. I see. Got it. Yeah, it was in the top left. All right. Now I'm with it. Okay. Got it. Gold dwell. Yep. Definitely got it. Okay. I'm with it. Internal screaming can stop. Oh my god. No, it's got to be a barbarian. Charlatan. Yes, that's good. Perfect. All right. Edit appearance. Sorry, I'm going to be as quick as I can. Maturity, older, the default genitals, sure. That'll do. That one, right, that first one was pretty good. Alright,
those re-
There's magic keep-
Where to next?
Let's hope the locals are friendly.
Hells, something just woke up down here.
That, sure, that's fine. No body art. Eyes, makeup, none. Hair. Oh, do I have to have a beard? No, facial hair is an option. There we go. And then, we just want the mustache. Oh, yes! There it is. Good. Alright, I'm good. Got it. Got there in the end. I need a guardian. Drow, Thieveling. Do you have a recommendation for that? For a guardian?
I don't know. It's kind of just make your... Originally, it was make your bae, basically.
I know. Make Waluigi. That's a good idea. That's a very good idea. But... Can I customize the appearance of it or no?
Yeah.
Choose a guardian, race sub. Oh, yeah, you can. Okay. Good. That's a very good idea, Kat. Elf or high. I think high elf. And then. High elf. Okay. Excellent idea.
Follow your instincts.
Don't
be afraid.
Wait, but it's like. Defaulting. Or can this only be? Hang on. General, male. Identity, male. But then the face is still... not very male looking. Body type? Oh, down... See, it moved it down the bottom. It was at the top before. Don't blame me on this one. This is like... they moved it. Yeah, it's down the bottom now. Alright, we're back in business. Eyes, it's the same. Hair, it's pretty much the same, but then we want that. Where's this? I need the same hair, like that one. Yep. Highlights, just like that, it's fine. Graying is fine. I can't give it a name though, right? It's just...
No, it's just the guardian.
Okay, yeah. This canonically, this is Waluigi. This is fine. It's not bad. I mean, it's just the facial expression is lacking the look. It does look pretty nice though. I assume I'll be able to change my clothing to be of a different color. I've just got to make it yellow and purple, and then we're done.
Yeah, there are dyes and such as well, so...
Yeah, cool. Curious to see what you made.
Almost there.
It's alright, I... took just as long. My other idea was to make syrup, which is the person that always tricks Wario into going to get money. And then she just makes off with it every time. Sometimes she's the last boss in the game. Is there anything from a continuity point of view that I should know of, like story-wise? Or world lore stuff?
Let's see.
Whilst we're sitting. I mean, okay, there's the Mind Flayer thing.
Yeah, the Mind Flayers are big. They're gonna be a big part of everything that's going on. Basically, the intro of the game shows Baldur's Gate, which is one of the biggest cities in this area. Having a Mind Flayer ship show up above it all of a sudden and just start kidnapping people straight out of the city.
Right.
But once we actually start, you'll see that. It does a good job of providing context. Like, you know, Baldur's Gate has three games worth of things that have happened in history that has been going on. And then on top of that, Baldur's Gate is also a D&D setting in itself. But it does a good job of kind of like telling you what's going on for the most part.
One thing I was a fan of, not in this game, but Final Fantasy 16 had this just very quick lore thing that you could just press a button and based on what the characters were talking about, it'd be like, oh yeah, this is what they're talking about. Which was, I thought, a pretty neat feature. Because there's that series has just so much lore in it. So as long as it's easy on that. Proficiency, simple weapons, martial weapons, battle axes, hand axes, light hammers, war hammers, light and medium, shields, athletics, sleight of hands, perception, deception. Very low in intelligence. I have 10 charisma. It's like kind of charismatic. I have to bump that stat up. Gonna be like the charismatic warrior. I mean, everything is like double digits except intelligence. Oh, I forgot the quote that Wario says about the brain. It's like, oh, that's right. He says he has a smooth brain, and it's a good thing. It means that it hasn't been used and it's in pristine condition. Only those that use their brains and are all worn out have wrinkly brains.
That's pretty funny.
So, pristine brain in pristine condition. I'm kind of afraid, like, what are you making? It's
Nothing untoward.
Uh-huh. Just hearing the click, 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 click.
What you're hearing is, art.
Art.
Yes, that's the sound you're hearing.
Just attention to detail being made. Meanwhile, just went with the low-hanging fruit. The song that's playing right now is like the most RPG of RPG music I've heard. The only thing missing is just a bard singing. These dwarves are known for their confidence and keen intuition. Their culture of their deep kingdom values family, ritual, and fine craftsmanship. When you play these games, you always want to be up. Well, I have more Yuzu Pale Ale, so that's what I'm having right now. Funny you should say that. Whoa, I didn't see. Okay, it didn't show you.
Oh yeah, you'll see.
I'll see you. All right. Probably move the cursor out of the way. There we go.
Yeah, so that city is Baldur's Gate.
Right. Oh, damn. Wait, was that the Wilhelm scream?
The Wilhelm scream? Let's go.
I mean, I have questions about, like, the tentacles just acting as what seems to be a power source.
Yeah, my players have, their technology has that, like, biotechnology thing going on for you.
Yeah, he's just connecting random tentacles to one another to do things.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, it's a for some reason I feel like they're just gonna bring Baldur's Gate over those. Title drop.
Mm-hmm.
Private dialogue, guess not. Dialogue history.
So the little private dialogue box is because I can listen in onto your conversations.
Ah, gotcha.
And like see what you're seeing. So for whatever reason you don't want me to do that, you can private your dialogue.
Wait, Chad?
I am Chad.
Okay.
So my recommendation for this game is just any, you know, it very much rewards exploring shit and interacting with things.
All right.
Oh, I feel dead. Better. Good.
It was like, I feel, and then you said dead.
Dead.
Okay. Nothing here. Rage charge. Okay, well, we'll see where this goes.
Someone else got out. Like not getting back in that thing.
Alright, let's just get out of here.
Not getting back in that thing.
I'm gonna try not to influence you too much, Skivvy. Yeah, the flesh doors are pretty gross.
Yeah, well, just the fact that it's a sphincter. Oh. That's how it works.
So I do recommend we go up here into this thing.
Ooh.
Touch this. That guy in the chair over there is a
brain job. Something
interesting to look at. Yeah.
Anything.
Doesn't do
Can't anything. Use this right now. We are here.
Here. Your character is so good. To save us
from this place. The voice.
Please. Before they return. They return.
That facial
expression. So, you see how up in the top left it's like said perception check failed?
Yeah.
Did you see that?
Yeah.
So basically that's like a D&D thing. So there's something that you could have perceived about this brain, but it rolled based on your perception and you failed, so you didn't perceive it. Does that make right. sense?
Yeah, I gotcha.
Like, you weren't perceptive enough to perceive whatever you could have perceived about it. And that's basically the basis of D&D right there.
A newborn. Born new from this husk.
You realize you're talking to an intellect devourer. A minion of the Mind Flayers who abducted you.
Destroy the brain. Leave. Yeah, I'm leaving. I'm not touching that. That's like...
Sometimes...
The facial
don't
expression...
Don't touch the thing is the right option, for sure.
Yeah. It's just like... You know how sometimes people ask you a question and they give you two options and you don't like either option? It's like, oh, you just don't answer the fucking question and just walk away.
Yeah. I'm gonna let you walk forward first because things happen and I want you to be the center of the cutscenes and stuff.
This
rush past. A dragon's wing, a silver sword, and a flash of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
Oh, my head. What is this?
So the only thing I remember when you played this, the beta, was just some of the faces looked very janky, but it seems like that's not the case anymore.
Oh yeah, it was... It's still a bit glitchy at times, but man, is it has improved since early access.
We carry mind flayer parasites. Unless we escape, unless we are cleansed, our bodies and minds will be tainted and twisted. Within days, we will be Geth, mind flayers. We can do nothing until we escape. That must be our priority. First, we exterminate the imps. Then we find the helm and take control of the ship. We will address the matter of a cure for this infection once we reach the material.
Man, my mustache just looks glorious.
It does.
It's just the pose as well is just looking so proud. Combat, get ready to fight.
So something you can do right off the bat, once you're kind of through your little combat tutorial thing, is if you hit escape and go into multiplayer.
I think I can do it now, yeah.
You see how Lazelle's portrait is right under yours?
Yeah.
You can pass her over to me, because otherwise you have to control her in the turns.
Ah.
So if you want to control her, that's all good. But otherwise, I can just kind of take care of the NPC stuff so you can focus on, like, learning what you're doing, you know?
Good. Do that. Handballing. Yeah, and then hit apply. Handballing. I did.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, I can see it. Okay, so...
So yeah, now I take control of her and you don't have to worry about that.
And then, oh, I see the red is, like, how much I can do in, like... So I have action points that I can do, and then space and turn.
Yeah, certain amount of movement, certain amount of actions you can do every turn.
Gotcha. I can pan, there we go, I can pan, got it.
Aha.
Oh, you already got it. Looks to me. Surprisingly adequate in battle. Now, to the helm. Crossbow. Yeah. I mean, should I be picking up random junk that's not for me?
Yeah.
Okay.
You don't want to hoard too badly. Because you do have, like, a weight limit.
Yeah, I figured.
Generally, it's worth picking most things up just to sell.
I'll take one crossbow. I did find a sword, though.
Yeah, for your class, too, it is nice to have a ranged same. Option.
Oh, I should have a ranged option.
Like, cause a lot of times what will happen is you'll run out of movement, and so...
Ah,
you can still fire an arrow even if it's not, you're not, like, specifically a ranger. It's still just good to happen to have that option.
Simple robe, sword shield.
Yeah, and anytime we have a shared inventory, if you hit tab, you could just kind of, like, give and take things.
Okay. Got it.
So it doesn't matter who loots things until we start dealing with weight limits.
Oh, there's nothing this way. Just seeing where you can and can't go.
Yeah.
That's the name of that door. Ugh, it just makes the entrance just so much worse.
Mind flayer machinery. Better watch what I touch.
Sacrifice cultist?
The man isn't dead, but he's totally unresponsive.
Apparently I can just barbarian. Yes. Damn it. Don't give up. Tear this thing open.
Skill there we go. Here, hold on. So I have an ability called guidance. And I can give that to you like that. And now you have another D4 that's going to add to your roll.
All right. Alright, click dice to roll.
Success. Hey.
Brute force prevails.
You just broke it. That's amazing.
Oh, yes! By finding a key, who cares? Oh man, I am very, very short.
I thought that damn thing was going to be my coffin. Thank you.
Your mind lurches into her thoughts. Her gratitude is mixed with wariness. Because you have a gift with you.
You keep dangerous company.
Okay.
I did. It must be because of those parasites they put in us. They'll have to wait. I need to get off this ship alive first. Let me come with you. We can get off this ship and watch each other's backs along the way.
No, get out of here! Alright, sure.
Shadowheart. One moment.
So what do you do if you... I mean, I tore it open, but what are you supposed to do?
Well, you can leave her there.
Trust me, there's no chance.
But to get her out, usually. Lead the
way. There's also a few different ways you can get it open. But a brute force definitely makes sense from the barbarian perspective. I had no idea you could brute force it open, so
oh,
I was
really?
Hilarious. Yeah.
Fuck yeah. The option just like, no, don't give up, try again. It's great. Wait, what's going on here? Why is my camera all weird? Oh. It just... That was...
If your camera's ever, like, stuck, by the way, you can always just double-click your character's portrait, and it'll, like, reset it.
It just... When I approached that door, it just went all weird. Like, I couldn't see the door, and it just went black. It's alright, it's fine now. That was weird.
Oh yeah, if you hit escape again too, you can give a shadow heart to me as well. I can control her.
Escape. Multiplayer. Yeah, just take the casual approach. It's gonna be great. Brute force is gonna be a constant option. Push. I'm not gonna stick my hand into things. That's.
I love the hesitation. Like,
Well, it's just like stick your hand into a foreign device. I don't think we need to be here. Wait, where's Matt? Okay. Yeah, the quest is not in this direction, so let's just keep...
keep on keeping on.
Yeah, I'm not going to stick my hand into something that is foreign, especially when the doors are called sphincters. I don't want to know what that is.
You know, I feel like that's a fair way to think about it. But some people, I feel like, are just overtaken by the touch the button.
What's this? Aquarium?
We're nearing the helm. Once inside, do as I say. Who put you in charge? I'll trust my own judgment. Kanyank.
Step in.
You may have walked through a little bit of fire. It's okay.
I'm still. Oh, I'm on fire. Whatever.
Right, hold on. This is this is what I'm here for.
Well, like, to cure me from self-immolation. Ugh. Oh.
So basically, we're trying to run to touch the thing at the end of the room with the tentacle stuff going on.
Gotcha. I mean, I've been hearing a lot about this game lately. Like, it seems to have just exploded in terms of people playing it.
Yeah, it is definitely blown up really hard. I think... I mean, I personally was a Divinity 2 like mega fan, basically, so I've been waiting on this game for a minute, but I think it's like kind of perfectly riding the trendiness and like re-uprising of D&D as well.
Right.
It's just like a part of that wave, you know?
This music. Oh. I mean, it's definitely good, just because I can kick back.
Yeah, so if you look at your little action bar on the left, by the way.
On
you
the
see
left.
Where it has just like jump and hide and all that stuff.
Oh wait, jump. Oh yeah, hide, yeah.
Throw. So it's important to know about all that stuff. So like you can use your action, which normally you would use to attack or do something else. If you can't reach anything to do any damage, you can use it to dash instead and just double your movement.
Right.
So you can just get further. So, you know, like, on Shadow Heart here, I'm going to hit dash and then use it. And now I can kind of, like, move further because I can't really do anything else anyways.
Okay, I see. And then I can...
Hurry before they strike.
And then go further distance. Okay. That makes sense. I have one that's like makeshift weapon. Just use something or someone as a weapon.
Yeah, so if something's light enough, you can literally pick it up and use it as a weapon.
I like the idea of that. Oh, that is quite the distance. Ooh, I found the pearl. I'm just running behind you, just looting the bodies.
No. Son of a bitch.
Unlucky.
So I'm gonna just let you get to the thing. We still have 12 rounds, so it should be enough time.
12 rounds?
Yeah. More than enough time.
Okay. The only thing I will say is, like, just the camera sometimes.
Yeah, it's a bit weird.
But gotten used to it. Dash.
You should be able to just touch the thing. Yep, there we go.
The helm's alien transponder.
Touch the tentacles. Oh, man. I don't like how that thing's flapping like that.
Yeah, mind flayers are pretty gross. Everything about them is pretty gross.
Oh, damn, the loading takes a while. Or at least here it does. This computer's starting to feel its age.
Yeah, same with mine.
What is that facial expression? Like, very skeptical, confused as what's going on, I guess.
Just gives me like,
Look, all right, that's what I was gathering. Oh, no.
Seeing the dwarf careening through the air is amazing.
I'm sorry. That just took me by surprise. Just. It was like something that would certainly happen to Wario.
Just the random debris fucking clocking you right in the head.
So it's like cartoon.
Yeah.
Cartoon comedy.
As you wake, the tadpole squirms in your skull. The chaos of the crash site confuses the landscape. You'll need to find a settlement or landmark, and you'll need to do it quickly. The tadpole is a death sentence, and the clock is ticking.
Chad is trying to listen. What are you listening? Okay, find a cure. If there's anything behind. Oh, right. Waker.
You're alive.
The silent protagonist thing.
Yeah.
How is this possible? I remember the ship. I remember falling. Then nothing.
Okay.
You might want to reconsider calling her a friend. Looks like she ran off without us. First things first, we need supplies, shelter, and most of all, a healer. We might have escaped, but we still have these little monsters in our heads. No, I don't recognize this place. But anything's an improvement on where we just came from. We need each other. And we both know what's at stake. Can't think of better company.
I mean, in the interest of making things...
Just before we go.
Varied.
I wanted to thank you again. For freeing me. It would have been all too easy for you to run right past my pod. But you didn't. I'll remember. Lead the way.
Yeah, you can like give her to me again.
Oh.
Fortunately, every time we pick someone up, you're gonna have to do that, but it's still easier than
Having
to learn multiple classes to play the other characters.
It's fair. I mean, this is giving me Divinity 2 vibes.
Yeah, sure. It's very much. A successor, for sure.
Perfume letter. The read. Sai, I love you. There, I said it. If you meet me tomorrow, I'll say it again and again. We keep on saying it till we're old and gray, so let's do it. Let's go to Baldur's Gate. I know it's risky, but so staying here. The last few months have been hard, but they're always a little easier when you're there. Leave your boat and meet me at the hill overlooking the old bridge. Bring whatever you can carry. We'll do. We'll make do without the rest. Don't be late, Anna.
Here's that didn't work out so good.
No. It's just the Times New Roman. There's a song here, apparently. And the bitch queen stays the storm. Okay.
I love being able to see your first impression of this game. It's just so good.
Bish. In a bottle.
Yeah, food and stuff actually matters, because when we go, like, to recover health and stuff in this game, basically we have to go to camp and, like, end the day. Yeah, to be able to heal fully, we have to have food and stuff. So anytime you see anything that's, like, camp supplies, worth picking up.
Sigil Circle, I imagine, is just fast travel.
Yep, that's a fast travel point.
Okay. Tell her I'll pay good gold for her breech cloth.
Can't get that open easily. Maybe there's another entrance.
Okay.
What's a breech cloth?
I have no idea. That's what I was gonna ask. It was purple and gold. What was what? Where? The corpse? The loincloth? Whose loincloth? it's past the point now where it's just like,
Didn't we not walk into the fire? Is that like a possibility for you?
I looked at the...
Are you just like a moth to the flame? Are you just... Can you not help yourself?
I looked at the window for a sec, and then I was on fire.
This is exactly why I chose a cleric to be with you. Like, you're just...
Look, man, like, my intelligence is 8, okay? I can rip open the door, but
that's why you have Chad. Chad will be there for you.
I can rip open the door. High ground rules. Okay.
Yeah, that's a thing in Divinity 2 as well. Attacking from high ground generally gives you
advantages. Critical mass!
It means you literally rolled a 1.
Oh my god. Alright, well, I can't move now. Shove. That was... Yeah!
Yeah. It was already dead, but you know, it's about the thought.
Oh, I was being rude, just kicking it while it's down.
Hey, we leveled up.
It's just gonna be a count on the number of times I light myself on fire.
Yeah, how many times you light yourself on fire and I have to heal you for the damage you took? Son of a bitch. Hey, you pushed it into the fire. Look at that.
Yeah.
That's using that 8 intelligence. So we leveled up, so you can see on our portraits on the left, you can click the little golden arrow. Yeah.
Danger sense. Sense when things aren't as they should be. You have an advantage on... Dexterity saving throw. What's a saving throw?
So, a saving throw is like... How to explain this? So, like, if you are trying to walk across a slippery surface like grease, every so often it's going to make you take a saving throw to not slip and fall on your ass.
Right.
So the higher your dexterity, the more likely you are to be able to walk across the grease without falling. And so anything that, like, requires dexterity, that's basically what that is. You know, so like,
if there's a trap and I go over that trap, it means
you have a higher chance to like not or take less or take no damage from the trap, basically.
Gotcha. Yeah. I thought you were going to say, if you were to walk over a surface, like let's say fire.
Well, if you just walk yourself into fire, you know, that's a different problem entirely.
Reckless attack. Ooh, okay. So I don't put points into anything, it's just like all automatic?
Right now it is.
Okay.
Barbarian is a good place to start because it's very like, you don't do any spell casting and stuff, so
yeah.
It's really straightforward.
That's what I figured. Yeah. Lock it. Well, not.
Things get a bit more complicated when you're looking at magic and stuff like that.
Stick them with my axe.
It's poison and random stuff in that chest I already looted.
Well, I've got keys, so I guess we can go back now. That's a lot of blood.
Yeah, it's... This game's not kidding around with its mature rating, dude.
I mean, yeah, damn. Wait. Didn't I get keys? It says key. Keychain.
Whatever. It just means whatever key you got is not for that door. If you do have the key, it'll automatically open it.
Okay, then we don't have the key. Just saw a keychain. And it was like, oh, we have it. Can't brute strength that one.
Nope.
Climb up here? I can. There's nothing here. It's just not worth the climb. Nice time waste.
It is good that you have a natural reaction to want to explore little nooks and crevices, though, because the game definitely does reward you for that at times. Not every time, but at times.
Yeah, it's just the Zelda 1 mentality.
Mm-hmm.
Skull. Caustic bulb. I'll leave the skull. I imagine it's just junk.
Pretty much, yeah.
Footprints. There may be even more that survived the crash.
Footprints. There may be even more that survived the crash.
That's what I just said.
She wanted to say it too, man.
It's almost like, oh, I came up with the idea.
Yeah.
It's like, when you have an idea, you say it out loud, and then someone, some other asshole goes, hey, I got this great idea.
Yeah.
What if we did this?
That's 100% happened to me in real life before, I swear.
Yeah, same. a slide. Looks like I can slide down this. I can't slide down it. Another dead end.
Well,
would have been cool just to slide down it. It's slide shaped. I'm small enough.
There's an injured mind flayer under that rubble there.
Where?
In the middle of the room.
Can you ping?
I actually.
No, oh, how do you ping?
It's left alt right mouse. Abducted
you. You okay. Could end its life here and now if only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion. Compassion.
You can't move, can't think. Thinking is mercifully done for you. It will be a joy to serve, to die for it an honor. It's possessing your mind, forcing you to love it. But then the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere.
Intelligence concentrates on folk. I can't do intelligence.
Yeah, we know for a fact you're not very good at that.
The monster lies exhausted, defeated. Its eyes wet orange pearls.
I mean, you never know. Like, you can succeed, right? It's just low chance.
Yeah, it's just RNG.
I should have just gone for it.
God damn.
But then, you know...
Monster. Death is too good for it.
It's hardcore.
Some point. Gotta play the part.
Yep. Very much a barbarian way of taking care of that situation.
Yep. I mean, so far I've walked into fire like it's nothing, ripped open doors, and stomped the head in.
There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? I was hoping for a kind soul. Well, not to worry.
Really? Strength! Doing the roll. I mean, it's only a 10, right?
Mm-hmm.
There nice. You go. Brute force.
I saw you on the ship, strutting about whilst I was trapped in that pod. What did you and those tentacled freaks do to me? I'm not an idiot. I saw... Ah!
Your mind twists. You're looking out of unfamiliar eyes, prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light, the fear.
What was that? What's going on?
He might believe me now.
The worm. Of course. That explains things somewhat. And to think. I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies. Indeed we are. Please, allow me to introduce myself. My name's...
Does this dude have vampire teeth?
I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me.
Oh.
Is that so? We clearly move in different circles. So, do you know anything about these worms? Turn us into... Of it'll turn me into a monster. What else did I expect? Although, it hasn't happened yet. If we can find an expert, someone that can control these things, there might still be time. Well, yes, of course. But first things first.
Oh. I mean, I don't know you.
I was ready to go this alone. But maybe sticking with the herd isn't a bad idea. Safety in numbers, after all. And I hate to turn down an invitation. All right. Maybe I'll see you there. Good luck.
I don't know how I feel about this guy.
He seems pretty trustworthy to me.
Oh, you mean like knife to the throat trustworthy?
Yeah.
Well, he headed off in that direction.
I hear Shadowheart's got some decks going on so she can pick lock this chest here, this trunk.
Wait, why can I drag and drop stuff?
You can, like, move stuff around.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Is there any benefit to that? Other than getting shit out of the way? It can be sometimes.
Most of the time, no, but on occasion, there's, like, a puzzle or something, you know? There's something hidden. That type of deal. What?
Just jump into
the water?
Yeah, because there was like a little corner. I was like, oh, what's in that corner? And it's just like, the pop-up came up and said jump. I'm like, all right, I'll jump. And then I jumped and I
This is going to be a hard life, isn't it? Being your cleric is going to be a hard life.
If you were to watch the footage, you would have seen the chain of events. I tried to walk to the corner there. I was like, oh, maybe there's something hidden there. Then a little pop-up said, oh, if you can't reach it, jump. So I jumped. The pop-ups, the tutorial led me astray. But like, if you're right, I'm fucked either way. Ugh.
Just hold on. Just stay still. Just fucking stay still for a second. Don't kill yourself for just a little bit longer.
I'm like a fucking lemming. If you take your eyes off me for a second, I'm either on fire or drowning myself.
Well, I'm over there, like, picklocking a chest open for, like, gear and potions and stuff, and you're just, like, jumping to your death in a puddle. This is how it's gonna be, huh? This is the way this is gonna go.
Intelligence 8, that's all I'm gonna say. Oh, my stomach.
Oh, Chad. Had no idea what you were getting into following this dwarf around.
It's a movie, it kind of writes itself. I'm the comedic relief. What's wrong with the boar?
Hey.
I should be able to do it.
The boar grunts and eyes you warily with its beady eyes.
The boar shuffles its trotters, unsure. Then it dashes away into the wilderness.
Aw. Damn. Oh well.
So what were you hoping to get out of that?
I don't know. Make a friend. Get a pet.
That's fair.
The boar comes along with us. I call him Pumbaa and he's my best friend.
Yeah, that would be, that'd be on, pretty on point for the general vibe of this party, I feel like.
Just after drowning, life-death experience, reevaluate my life and realize I need a really good friend. But hang on, where haven't we been? Oh, there's a walkway under, I see. Was the pig trying
crispy
to
crispy bacon.
Crispy bacon, yeah. Well, it's a boar, not a pig. Do you get bacon out of boars?
I guess you could have wild bacon. Like, boars are more or less just wild pigs.
Wait, what's a pathway down? Can't get here.
You have to jump.
I mean, the last time I did this.
It's low.
Shit.
It's a very circumstantial thing. Oh, here. Here's an opportunity to show you how moving things can be helpful sometimes. So you can pick up that rock and move it if you're strong enough. Which you should be.
Drag and drop? Oh, yeah.
There you go.
Jeez. I clicked it. There. Ah. Harper's notebook. Potion of speed. Gold. Ruby. Harper's map. What is this map? Stained ragged map has been passed through countless hands. Mark's an area called Moonrise Towers with a small inky crescent sketched in the nearby forest. Below the crescent is a more recent scroll cache. Okay.
Treasure map. Cache map.
Wild bacon sounds like a strip club for cops.
I'd be all about that, honestly.
The wild bacon.
Are all the strippers cops, or is it a strip club for cops?
Yeah, it's like, is it ex-cop stripping, or is it... It's like quite the Mario jump. Have you been over here?
I'm always somewhat worried about you now.
Like, just approaching the ledge and you're just watching intently, like, okay, what's he gonna do?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I guess further north then. It's alright, just think of the content.
Yeah.
I mean, me jumping
into
that.
I'm also out of spell slots right now, so
if
you walk through more fire, I can't heal you.
Stakes are even higher.
Actually, no, I think Shadowheart still got some, she can heal you. But still, we're running low on healing juice.
So, on the topic of fire...
Yes. There you go. That's the ticket.
You know what it was? It was like... You remember how when GPS maps first came out on phones? How people used to drive into lakes and shit? I just drove into a lake with my character.
Yeah. That is a very good comparison, honestly.
It told me to jump, I jumped without question, and I went in the lake.
You just didn't question it. Did as you were told.
Oh, shit. I can hear someone.
There's some people talking over there.
I thought I could jump up there.
Oh, also, F5 is your best friend.
F5?
It's a quick save.
Oh, gotcha.
It's an easy way to lay down a save without having to do the whole saving process. As tall as me,
but
I'm half that
bloody backbone! But we don't know what that thing even is. And what about the crypt?
I'm telling you, it's a ship. And the crypt can wait. Mari and Barton have been trying to break in for days. Now we... Stop! Got ourselves competition already.
That's our... Walk out of the woods.
Reason barbarian.
Well, in that case, come on, you lot. No point in getting killed. Second worm gets the cheese and all.
Second mouse gets the cheese. No?
Nobody's
I've never heard that expression.
Now move it!
Or it's because the first mouse dies to the trap and then the second
exactly.
mouse. Yeah.
I thought we had a fight on our hands.
No, it's just Wario. I just intimidated the fuck out of them.
Mm-hmm.
So far, I'm on point.
He's pretty intimidating.
Ripped the door open and just told them, nope, go away. This crate here. Okay.
Wouldn't take much to send that stone crashing downwards.
Can I shut this? This is like a puzzle? First melee help.
So if you point your mouse over the rope, you see how up the top it says coiled rope and it actually has health?
Coiled rope and then actually okay, yep.
So do you have your crossbow
equipped? I don't have it equipped, but I can.
Okay, so just equip your crossbow real quick.
Do you have like a second loader? A range, there we go.
Yeah, and then you can select a range attack and then make a range attack on it. There you go.
There's, well, I fell.
And he just went down the hole. As expected.
In. It just fell in.
As expected.
I fell in.
And there are people angry at us down here.
Okay, well.
Hope your soul is in good hands.
You ready? Watch this shit.
If you look at what happened on my screen, I just slipped down the... Oh my god.
Aha!
Blew them all up, alright. Hey. That one survived. Oh, 1 HP.
Two of them survived, the other guy... There's another one with 5 HP over there.
Oh yeah, I see it.
Behind the door.
Hasid. Hasid.
Son of a bitch.
Wow, that's unlucky. Oh, well,
it's okay, she burned to death.
There we go. Ooh, a great club. Tenacity, when you miss an attack, you deal 3 bludgeoning damage anyway. Hell yeah.
It's pretty good.
Boots, gloves.
So in terms of armor, part of the barbarian's thing is that they don't really wear armor.
Really?
You're like stronger by not wearing armor, basically. So when you look at a piece of armor, like leather armor, for example, underneath it, it says light armor, right? So the things you can wear are going to be clothing instead of armor. Like where it says light armor, it'll say clothing instead. Like if you put armor on, you'll like lose the ability to rage and like do all your barbarian stuff, basically.
That one doesn't say clothing. But I think I got what you mean. Like leather gloves, for example, you off with don't... decent...
Yeah.
We're fine. I gotcha. Where's that club? That's cool. It does less damage, but then it's... If I miss, it does damage anyway, so that's a good balance.
Still does damage, yeah, that's pretty good.
I'm hoping to see the option where I can just break down a door again. Oh, okay.
Oh.
Over here! We got company!
Oh, that nice. Sounded good.
It's brutal.
That sounded good. Dazed.
Guys having a real bad day.
So, would this dude have alerted things? Said over here we have company. I was assuming he was alerting.
Well, he didn't know his other friends were dead.
Yeah. Ooh, there's a cheese wheel. The patron god of this
place? Whoever that even is. No intact symbols here.
Yeah, anything food is worth picking up.
Yeah, I'm looking. Another cheese wedge? Hell yeah.
We eating good tonight, bro.
Like fish and cheese.
Whole ass cheese wedges and fish. Fish and cheese doesn't really go together in very many things.
No.
Not sure I could come up with a fish and cheese dish off the top of my head, even.
Just looking in
the room. Anything alcohol counts as,
food.
Camp supplies as well.
Okay.
So, like, all this wine, this more cheese. Cool. That went surprisingly well, considering the fact you just fell down the hole.
Comedy. There's like a statue here.
We discovered a lever in the wall.
But did the lever do anything?
Did you pull it?
No.
Do you want to pull it?
Lighting the things first. Maybe pull it now. Where's the lever? Candles? I know, there's more candles.
It's right there on the wall.
Left or right side?
Right by the looter's trunk.
Right by the looter's trunk. Must be blind. Candles. Brazier. Oh, there? I don't see in it. I don't see that.
You don't see anything?
No, I don't. No, there's nothing here.
Oh, maybe you failed your perception check to see if then.
Yeah. Spin camera. I don't know how to spin camera.
If you hold down middle mouse button.
Oh, there. No, it's Q and E.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Q and E also.
Does nothing.
I guess you just weren't perceptive enough to see it.
Nope. I mean, it fell down this hall.
Yeah. It checks out, for sure. Hey, Seth, by the way.
Yeah, hey, Seth.
Alright. We go through this door.
Dank.
This place wasn't built for the living.
Yeah. We could probably sell the valuables. This game is good. Just getting into it now.
Yeah, so I'm deep. I'm into like Act 2 at the moment. I'm already like 100 something hours in, I think.
Yeah, I've never played a game in this series before, but got convinced to try it. But also, it's been like a while since we've hung out and played games, so. Locked. Yeah. I mean, if nothing else, it's gonna be funny for the content. Heavy oak doors. Oh, these opened.
Still in Act 1. Yeah, that's fair, man. It's deception, it's a lot. Fail. There's a lot. I same. Also failed to receive it.
Wow.
Yep.
Another, I would imagine there's another trap.
Don't have a disarm kit.
Ooh, this room.
Absolutely full of traps.
Yeah, it's gone off twice more. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, so these aren't trapped.
Soul coin. Onyx ring.
Strange coin. I wonder what it's worth.
Okay, so here, just stand over here. We'll take care of this.
Okay.
Just stay right over here.
Like as far away as possible.
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay, what are you gonna do?
Don't worry about it.
Turn-based mode. Time is broken down into 6 rounds. Okay.
Yeah, you could basically go in and out of turn-based mode at any time to, like, be able to utilize each move, you know, rather than have things happen in real time.
Hmm.
So now I, like, looted the sarcophagus, and then I jumped over the grease, and if we end turn-based mode, everything happens.
Shit.
And that's the trap. As you can see, it would have been unfortunate if we were in there for that, say the least.
Jeez. Okay, well, good to know.
But it's a good teaching moment, so you can see the value of turn-based mode, you know? But, yeah, I got the key for this door out of that sarcophagus, so onward.
Would have been mildly unfortunate. Yeah, you should have seen what happened earlier.
But no sign of a struggle.
I've been playing the barbarian part pretty well. 8 intelligence.
He's walked directly into fire twice now.
Yeah.
He jumps directly into water and drown.
Well, I ripped the door off to rescue someone, so that was great. But I was trying to, like, walk into a corner. It's like, oh, there's probably a secret in this pocket. And then it said, you can't reach it, try jumping. So I tried jumping to the spot, and then I drowned because I jumped into a lake. It was like the early days of GPS when people would drive into lakes. That's basically what happened.
Pretty much.
That might be worth a look.
Well. Button has been pressed.
Go. They look angry.
Oh, hells. Something just woke up.
I mean, they're just skeletons. Seems fine.
Yeah, just skeletons. No big.
Nice. Oh, shit. That was...
That hurt quite a bit, actually.
Oh, lucky. I won't use rage yet.
Sucks to suck.
That one down. Stick the gold.
I just barely can't get out of this. Bullshit.
They're still targeting you with cold. There you go.
Oh. That hurt.
Oh, it's dead.
Yeah.
Okay, then.
Just the one more. Hiding in that corner with it.
Over there, yeah.
There we go.
Didn't want to surrender their valuables, even after death.
They were just defending their valuables, huh? Speaking of valuables, what was in there?
A lot of effort to hide one sarcophagus.
I'm just mildly covered in blood.
Just a bit.
Hello, friend.
So he has spoken, and so thou standest before me, right as always. What a curious way to awaken. Now, I have a question for thee. What is the worth of a single mortal's life?
Quite the question, let us speak by calling anything, what are you? Quite the question, what's the reason?
Curiosity. Nothing more. Wilt thou answer my question?
Alright.
So, I ask again, what is the worth of a single mortal life? I am curious by what standards thou shalt judge. Very well. I am satisfied. We have met, and I know thy face.
We will see each other again at the proper time and place.
Ominous.
Farewell.
That's why we're here. The Amulet of Lost Voices. Speak with the dead. Necromancy spell.
Necmus makes it so you can talk with corpses.
Right. I wonder what they're going to say.
Pretty much all she wrote in here, though. End of dungeon.
Is there a leave dungeon option?
Yeah, here. For this dungeon, there is.
I just meant like a shortcut, a key or something. I don't mind walking out. Convenient.
After you, Sarah. So I'll bring your attention real quick to the little campfire symbol in the bottom right of the action of the bar.
Yeah.
So that's the camp and resting menu. So we have two what are called short rests that basically just give us some health back, so I can use one of those.
That took the edge off.
And then once we're like out of resources, basically, eventually we have to like go to camp and take a long rest, and that's where we like spend food. It's kind of a little hub area. You can like talk to the characters you've recruited and all of that stuff too.
Gotcha.
Okay. We can dig that dirt mound if we had a shovel, but we do not.
Can't use my hands.
I guess not.
Can't dig like a dog. Okay, where are we going? I guess further down the path. Look at this one. I've got to rotate. It's a trap.
Must have been here a while.
What's this? Someone in a cage.
Zoru was right. Yellow as a toad, twice as ugly.
The thing's dangerous. Leave it for the goblins to kill.
And if it escapes, how will you? Oh, a guest.
Your skull pounds in response to the prisoner's white hot stare. Her lips don't move, yet you hear her voice.
Get rid of them.
Oh no.
Wait, I can roll again. What happens?
So, certain things you do will earn you inspiration. You know, so like, it depends on your class and your background and stuff. But like, for barbarians, it'll be like, I don't know, defeating a really strong enemy and you'll gain inspiration.
Right.
So you can use inspiration to reroll.
I swear if it fails again. That's a big
significantly better, yeah.
Like, fucking hell. It's only a five.
No one's safe if that thing goes loose. Not even us.
Damaze?
Enough. Lower the trap. Ready your blade.
So we're just gonna kill her, huh? So, you know, making sure that's the plan.
Well, it's a bit late for that now, huh?
Yep.
What were you expecting?
No, I'm just I'm along for the ride here, man. Just a passenger in your barbarian chaos. The fire and death. Oh.
I mean, it's not like we can backstab them now. Are we, like, we're killing a main character, aren't we?
I mean, kind of. That's the whole point of this type of game, though, is that you can do it.
Dead. Finally. Naimessa, are you alright?
I think so.
Together. We've got to finish what we started.
Yes, of course. Of course.
Do we even get anything for it? No?
But you get... I mean, she's dead.
Now come.
That's what you got out of it.
You didn't hear it. Shook our camp good, so we came for a look.
Nice.
Northwest. Look for Nettie. Whatever your wound, she can mend it.
And mind the goblin traps. Unless you relish a spit roasting.
Alchemy pouch. Keychain. Supply.
That sure is all her stuff. I'm gonna take her armor, actually.
There you go.
It's pretty good armor.
Longsword 4 to 13. Nah, I'll keep my club. Don't need the boots.
I'll take that as well.
Clothes? I mean... could take the clothes. And the boots.
You think I pull off her armor? I definitely got some booty cheekage hanging out in the back there.
Let's see. Oh no.
I'm really just... I'm trying to be true to my name.
Yeah, well... You know, this is non-stock playthrough. It's just like... shock value. That's what I'm going for.
Oh, you know, you... you live up to the name Wario very well. I gotta live up to Chad pretty well, you know? It's just gotta be this way. Like, I feel like I'm already starting to look like my name's Chad. You know what I mean?
All right. Now we can go to that place to go get heals.
Nope.
It's like, what do they say? Not over here. That's a cache. We can go there.
Yeah, that's the...
And then the healers
for the treasure map you found.
Yeah, okay. We'll go get the treasure. Yeah, do you know what it was? It's just... I feel like I've just had enough of the character that just misinterprets everything and takes things super literal, and then it becomes like a comedic crutch. It's just like, oh no.
Oh my fucking god.
It's okay, it's only full health, don't worry, it's fine.
Yeah, you're fine.
It's only full health.
Just singe like... some of your chest hair off. Oh, there's a shovel. Look at that.
Where? Oh, yeah. Do you want to go back?
We can, there's another
something here too. It's just, you know, they don't want that. The comedy relief of being too literal, so.
Yeah. No, you do you. I'm just gonna question your decisions. I'm not gonna sway them.
I mean, I felt the like confusion. I really did. It's like, are you sure this is what you want to do? Just double checking this is the plan. She's still there. Oh, shit.
She's not going anywhere. She's dead.
My plan was to get them to shoot her down and then backstab them, but then it was like, oh, that's not an option.
I'm not sure you have the intelligence to lie in such a devious way, you know?
Well, charisma should be
like
there.
I feel like Wario's thought processes are pretty straightforward.
It's true. The mound was somewhere around here.
Yeah,
you're over there at it, yeah.
There you are, sir.
Scroll of Thunderwave, not for me. Thunder!
You bear! Thunderstruck!
I'm doing Luigi from Mario Superstar Saga. So he says it.
There's something happening with that portal over there, by the way. You know, the big spinny purple hole over there.
I did notice that. I didn't want to go near it. It somehow looks unstable. So yeah, let's just click it.
You approach the sigil on the stone. Magic glitters and swirls from it erratically, as if malfunctioning. It looks slightly dangerous.
A hand? Anyone? This guy. Strength. I swear if I fail.
That's it. Go on. Keep pulling.
Hello.
Thought it was someone else.
Gale of Waterdeep. Apologies. Usually better at this. A bit shocked, but friend, it's a relief and a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Say, but I know you, don't I? In a manner of speaking. You were on the Norse Lloyd as well.
I can only assume you too were on the receiving end of a rather unwelcome insertion in the ocular region. The insertee we speak of, this parasite, are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it will turn us into mind flayers? It's a process known as seramorphosis, and let me assure you, it is to be avoided. You don't happen to be a cleric by any chance, do you? A doctor? Surgeon?
So what happens in the case of being a cleric? Can't you just heal yourself?
Well, that's what I am. Basically, you're just not powerful enough. I can offer swift end, but I can't cure you.
Now that option, that doesn't mean I'm going to attack him, does it?
No, it's just a barbarian specific strike.
Okay.
Not exactly a common affliction.
Just had to check.
Going to need a healer, and soon too. How about we lend each other a helping hand once more and look for a healer together?
Yeah.
Most excellent. A parasite shared is a parasite halved, or something to that effect. Oh, but before you think you're about to embark on a journey with most ill-mannered a man, thank you. For pulling me out of that stone. It was an act of foresighted kindness, I assure you. For I have the feeling ample opportunities will present themselves for me to return the favor.
Okay.
Yeah, you can give him to me as well.
I was already in the process.
Yeah. Hold on, let me level him up real quick.
Yeah, sure.
He needs to catch up to where we're at. Yeah, his whole thing is he's a wizard, so it's all spellcasting, so you definitely don't need to be dealing with that yet.
Yeah, good. So there's like a maximum party size with these NPCs, or?
Yeah.
Hmm.
It's like four, so you can only have, no matter what, you're going to have me with you.
Yeah, so it's basically two others.
Yeah, and so two others. Just pick and choose whichever ones you like, basically.
Well, I mean, there's one I can't choose anymore, but yeah.
Well, yeah, it may have something to do with the fact that you murdered her. It's just a theory, though.
I probably wasn't going to pick her anyway. Oh, man. That stuff. See what else I have.
Did you watch those back in the day?
Not that often. It was like every now and then I'd get linked to one of them, and just because it was just, I don't want to say the word cringe, but sometimes it was just like,
yeah,
oh man.
No, definitely. I'd say cringe is close enough.
The best way I can describe it is like the closest thing to tabloid journalism, only with video game lore.
Yeah, I mean, it was very much oriented towards children.
Yeah.
I feel like.
Yeah.
And like in that sense, I don't think it did anything especially egregious, but from adult perspective, it is very cringe.
Yeah.
Alright. Onward.
Do you ever see any of the
Brave Leader?
What the heck was that channel called? It was like called Gaming in the Clinton Years.
No.
So it's this channel that's popped up that's supposedly taking footage from a... I'm not going to walk into the fire, don't worry.
Don't fucking do it. I swear.
Supposedly, it was a show that ran on public access. I forget in what state. But it was just game reviews. But the way it's done is just... It's kind of just unbelievable. The opinions are very hot take. But it feels like it was a completely legit TV show. So there's always just debate about whether or not it was real, or it's just one of those things that someone has fabricated to make it look like it's something from the early 2000s.
Right.
Yeah. But like, you know, there's some of the reviews, like, on, they call very popular games bad. I think what was it, Donkey Kong Country, it said, if you don't like Donkey Kong Country, you're just wrong.
Open the bloody gate! Nobody gets in! Zevlor's orders!
But it's wild to watch those videos.
Goblins will be on us any second! What's going on? Goblins are on our tail! Open the gate, Zevlor, now!
For Tomb Raider, it was like a really weird one. It was just like, why can't we have... Oh, I forgot what it was, but it was just so fever dreamish. Just complaining about the characters' looks the whole time, pretty much. The triangle boobs.
The nine hells. Open the gate!
Maybe it's some, like, very deep satire, you know?
Yeah, I mean, that's what some people are saying. Other people say that it's for real.
Damnable roach. Provoke the blade. And suffer its sting.
That's a lot of people.
Yep.
I'll bleed every last one of you.
Dash. I like the implication that if I was playing by myself, that character would be in the party now, so you're wearing that armor, taking that slot up.
I'm just her now.
Haha. Aww. Hold on. I just thought of something. Sorry that it's muted, chat. I'm just doing something very, very important. Oh shit. Hold on. Wrong image. I dragged the wrong image out. This one.
Perfect.
Does that look good? I can't tell.
I think it looks bad in a good way.
Okay.
You know?
Gotcha. I was redoing my YouTube banners, so like... That's what that old image was. It's still not my turn. The only thing is, it's gonna be like a random graphic when cutscenes play, but... right now.
Nice.
Gonna go from the high ground, huh? Wait, what is grease? There's grease everywhere, Pia?
Yeah. That's what I was talking about. You can slip on it. It's also highly flammable.
Right.
So do with that what you will.
Well, I mean, it's not like I have the fire powers yet.
Betty Baytime Goblin.
Oof. Ha.
Oh, he tried to push you into the grease.
Yeah. Probably be doing a little better if I didn't step into fire.
Maybe. Once again, that's why I chose this class. Support.
Alright, well there goes that one.
Basically, what that's telling you is you're about to miss because you rolled a 9, but you can make it a reckless attack to gain advantage.
Sure.
Yeah, there you go. Went from miss to a hit.
I guess I can move here.
Also, don't feel afraid to use your rage as a barbarian. You pretty much want to be raging.
Okay.
The only thing with rage is you have to maintain it by either being damaged every turn or doing damage every turn.
It's a good thing I moved first.
You ever seen a flying goblin, Will?
No, I have not. What's it look like?
Looks like this.
There we go.
Hey!
The shove is great.
Oh! He threw a healing potion at you.
How nice.
How nice.
Yeah.
You fucking ready for this?
Go for it.
Burn! I love the environmental aspects of this. Definitely takes that from Divinity.
The shoving thing is pretty nice. Just tactical shove.
Success.
That was the last of them.
Inside, I mean, okay, there is a floating hat now, but...
It's alright. It's where it needs to be in most times.
Yeah.
Damn vermin.
There are children here, you fool!
We was running for our lives.
You led them straight to us, and you let them take the druid too? Unbelievable!
Tell that to the dead at the gate.
Shut it, Horns! I'd be lying dead next to the goblins if you'd stalled any longer.
My duty is to this camp.
Oh, God forbid you risk your precious tail.
That's
ice. I'd be surprised. Foulbloods ain't known for courage.
You see the tiefling's jaw clench.
Inside.
He's about to erupt.
The fucking barbarian option is to no caps.
Stop it or I'll bash the skulls together myself. Fuck yeah.
Eh, knock it out. Shut up! Got to be quiet, eh?
Amazing.
Enough! Squabbling is pointless. The goblins have found us.
At least we agree on that.
Okay, then we go break up the fight. Potato. A hat?
Not necessarily. I haven't made up my mind about you yet.
You find a hat?
I found a hat.
Incredible.
Look at that. It's like... I don't know. If I could draw, I swear, we need to find a dye shop. I need to be able to dye this hat and the robe yellow. We must make that happen.
We'll definitely keep an eye out for yellow dye. It has to be a thing. Alright, let's go up here first.
What?
There's some stuff to see up here.
Oh, man.
There's continue on over to the left there. Oh, yeah, some stuff over there as well.
Oh, there's a campfire. Yeah, that's what you were talking about, right?
No. So we can literally, like, go to camp at any time from anywhere, no. Mostly. But,
wooden crate.
Oh, careful with anything that's red, because it's considered stealing.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Well, I didn't take anything.
Luckily, nobody saw that. Yeah.
Crimes are frowned upon. It's okay, I didn't take anything anyway.
Over to the left here, there's some stuff you can get involved in.
What the? Whoa.
Have some respect.
What was that?
This really isn't the time to talk.
There you go, come over here.
Have some respect. What the fuck? That this just really looks so weird. Watch my screen. Watch my screen for a sec. Watch. Like, why is she just staring at my nipple really for the first time? <She's...
laughs> It's pretty hard not to look at it, bro.
Have some respect. This really isn't the time to talk.
Why is she staring at my nipple?
Have some respect. This really isn't the time to talk.
Oh, I mean, shit, honestly, how can you not stare at it? Look at it.
Oh, shit. I swear, hang on. I need to take the hat off the screen, and I need to get that without the hat on the screen. That's gonna be the thumbnail. Oh my god.
Have some respect. This really isn't the time to talk.
Okay, while you do that, I'm gonna refill my water real quick.
Okay. I just did it the side. Jeez. I have to find yellow dye. That's it. It's a mission. Oh. But see, this would be overkill. No, I mean, that's fine. I was gonna put it down the left as well, but... that was funny. I wonder how many people are not gonna like the fact that I killed a main character. Please. Someone's not gonna be happy.
Yeah, let's go up this way first.
Yeah, does that little icon with the up arrow mean like a quest?
That's a person up there.
Yeah, but it has an up arrow. Oh, that means just
it's
on
just
high
ground. It just means that it's above you. Yeah, it's higher ground than you are.
Gotcha. Okay.
Bugbear's trying to assassinate that tiefling.
Missed. I tried. Said surprised.
Goddamn.
That's the grease thing.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. It missed. Fearful.
Dude. He's still on fire, though.
What? Really? Yeah, I didn't want to walk into the fire.
Ignis!
Yeah. That's my contribution.
Hey, we leveled up again.
Never been much of a fighter, so wrestling a bugbear would have gone poorly. But you're not here for heroics, are you? Avernus's stench is all over your skin. Let me guess. Your devil mistress sent you to get her soul coin back. Too bad. I earned it, fair and square.
Deception, you got me. Hand the coin over and I'll be on my way.
Why, thank you, dread slayer of bugbears. You shall live forever in my memory. Now take my regards back to that pouting Irines and leave me alone.
I can intimidate. Okay.
Then our interests barely intersect. I'm sure there are other bugbears to kill. Best of luck finding them.
What's that all about?
From Hellspawn to Angry Druids, I'm definitely buying my way to Baldur's Gate.
Hmm. Okay. Rude.
She's pretty rude, isn't she?
Should have just intimidated.
Make sure to level up as well.
Oh yeah, right. Should probably lock my sources before it goes bad. Choices pending. Specialization available. Subclass Wildheart. Yeah. Speak with animals?
Yep, you can...
Bestial heart. Choose your bestial heart. You can change your bestial heart whenever you level up. Bear. Eagle. Jump distance. Do the bear. Bear pierce. Wait, piercing? I got a nose piercing. Ugh. I don't want that. Do I have to have the piercing?
You gotta get those piercings.
No piercings. No, thank you. Dwaria doesn't have piercings.
Yeah, I mean, I do think that subclass comes with the piercing, unfortunately.
It's okay. I didn't pick any. Didn't have to.
Here, go talk to... Here, go talk to that squirrel real quick. I want to... see your, Yeah.
Hey. Oh my god.
Get out.
What? Girl lunges at your Get foot out and bites it.
You barged in without an invitation. I wouldn't call that friendly. See, you're in my territory, and I want you gone.
There's plenty of room for both of us. Okay. Nine dot? What does that mean? damn.
No, the dot is just to differentiate between the six and the nine.
Okay.
Well, that went well.
Hey, Squirrel, come here. I'm talking to you again.
What did I tell you? Clear out!
Oh, well, it doesn't give you a second chance. I wonder what would have happened if I would have convinced it.
Just left to wonder now.
Okay, well. I mean, it was a 10. Does the squirrel just attack you if you don't talk to animals?
Either way, it bites your foot.
Yeah, right.
A few different things can happen depending on what you do with it. Oh, you probably want to talk to Zevlor here.
Forgive that display. Aradin's a blowhard, but that's no cause for me to join him. Thank you for your help out there. I'm Zevlor. Well met. I should warn you, visitors are no longer welcome in this grove. Whatever your business, I'd see to it quickly. The druids are forcing everyone out. This attack will only strengthen their resolve.
Okay.
There have been several attacks by different monsters. The druids blame us outsiders for drawing them here. Nobody's welcome anymore. They've started a ritual to cut the grove off from the world outside. We can't stay, but we'll be slaughtered if we leave. We're no fighters.
I need a healer.
The druid Halcyn's a renowned healer. But he didn't make it back from Aradin's expedition. If it's not too serious, you could try his apprentice, Nettie. She's with the other druids in the inner grove. They've withdrawn there to prepare this damn ritual of theirs. I've tried. Korga, their new first druid, won't even see me.
You got a new quest?
I know it's not your business. But she owes you for saving this place. Perhaps you could persuade her.
But those eyes have fire in them.
If nothing else. We'd owe you a great debt. If we're forced to leave now, we won't make it to the city. You'll find the druids at the heart of the grove. Please, make them see sense before more lives are lost.
Okay. Oh. Trade off? Like a sell stuff.
Refugees, adventurers. No one in years, and suddenly we're overwhelmed. Well met. And thank you for beating back those goblins. Most brave of you. Is there anything you need? Act fast if you do. The ritual will be complete before too long. I know it's drastic, but more monsters seem to terrorize this region every day. We druids will be safe. As for those that took refuge here, well, may Sylvanas guard them as they continue their travels.
Okay.
As I said, it's a drastic measure, but the survival of the grove is paramount. There just aren't enough supplies to support everyone. Just some bits and bobs I no longer need.
I will say, compare this to like the vendors in Diablo 4, this vendor has more personality than anything in Diablo 4.
Yeah, I mean, for all intents and purposes, this guy is literally just a vendor, but they still try to give him, like, this is a person.
This is a person, yeah.
You know, he's like a druid in this grove.
And he has a personality, like, at the end of the day, whereas in, I mean, typically with the Diablo games, you can name a vendor, and with D4, I can't.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't know the names, they're just not anything.
Yeah, they're literally just vendors. Vending machines.
Oh, yeah.
The cool thing about this game, too, is that you can trade with pretty much anybody. Even not if they right. aren't, like, vendors. Sometimes people just be willing to trade. Random stuff that they have.
I just sold all the random weapons. And I picked up some plates and stuff. I have a pearl. Should I hang on to that or sell it?
Nah, I think it's like gems and pearls.
No purpose for like a ruby?
Generally just money, yeah.
Okay, gotcha. With Garte as well?
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha.
Things that have like some kind of purpose with crafting or whatever will usually tell you in the item description.
Gotcha. Alright. No. Wait, so how do I...
Let's just look at the stream here real quick. Oh, so you have to hit barter? Or no, you have to hit the little scale above barter.
Oh.
Gotcha. Yeah,
not at all.
Yeah.
That was a little...
No, yeah, it doesn't explain that one very well, though.
No.
This is about your precious Baldur's Gate.
I care about our lives.
Sylvanas, guide our your futures.
Path. No, you just care about your stupid apprenticeship.
It's part of the world building. It's not that every character needs to have something that's memorable, right? It's just...
Yeah. They just need to have enough that it's like, okay, that's a person. You
know? Yeah.
They exist in this world and they're doing shit.
Oh yeah, I can talk to the animals. Which ox?
You don't have to recast it.
Strange ox.
Ah, you're addressing me, a humble ox. How quaint.
Are all the animals just weird? Oof. All right, come on. I think yeah. I got it. Yeah, got it. All right. What's strange about the ox?
This creature isn't what it appears to be.
No, you are incapable.
Out with a cow, you're going to regret it. Am I better on intimidation or persuasion? Persuasion's like,
if
what?
If you mouse over,
oh, roll 1d20. 1d20 situational deception plus 2 from deception proficiency. All right, it's a 10 either way. I'm glad I did that. Plus there 2 go. Charlatan, there we go.
I'd so love to see them try. I'll tell you this much, I'm going to Baldur's Gate with or without the rest of these poor sods. Now, that's all I have to say besides, and I really mean this. Moo. Nothing here for you.
That was it, really?
Mm-hmm.
What about Bordox?
Another one. What are you under there, then? Ant. Or rocks. If you do not like your form, then choose another. That is what the keepers of this place do.
Oh.
They become birds to hunt on the wing, bears to tear flesh with teeth. But for me, only oxen, only same old hay, and I cannot even eat it, because the horned ones hide their shiny bits inside. Hiding things, thinking they're clever.
What was with the zero that I just saw? Another zero. Why am I seeing a number zero randomly on the screen?
And they have to go looking for them on the other end.
I can't think it's because of the background. There's a teacher like hitting a dumb training dummy.
Yeah.
So for some reason, yeah, the damage is like coming through there.
Zero. So it says they hide stuff in there. I didn't click it.
I am hungry.
Okay.
Yeah, there's haystack next to me. Has some stuff in it.
We could at least make a run for it.
Pouch.
We don't even know these people.
That doesn't matter.
Of course it does. You would choose
anyone else to talk to here.
Look what I said. Stop shouting. Pretty much anyone that looks interesting.
Children. What I do
for some food. Look who's here.
Looks interesting.
I mean, it's kind of one of those things, like, talking to everybody is pretty worth it.
What a thrill for the children.
They're tough kids. Smart, too. The future's in good hands. Go on. Give me a best shot.
This dude called Will or Wile?
Will.
Oh my god. Hey, my dude.
But, you know,
my name is Will. Spelt with a Y.
Bro, my name's Will with a Y.
I do amateur bartending, my dude. Let me make you a beverage.
I'm not like you.
Umi, I don't need you to be like me. You just have to buy enough time to run. Come on. I believe in you. You can do this. You're on the right path, Umi. Go on now. Practice what you've learned. Well met.
Zero.
Frontiers at your...
The man's smile bends downward, and his thoughts become yours.
Another guy.
You are the blade of frontiers racing through the wastes of Avernus. Just ahead, a diabolical figure, red skin, single curled horn, blazes with flame, bloodied great axe held.
Hell's great fires. You are on the ship.
Okay.
Doomed to shed our skin and become a lithid, or so the stories go. But we haven't sprouted any tentacles. Not yet, anyway. Could just be good luck. I'm not so.
Your minds collide once more. Will chooses the fiend ignited with rancor.
When it happens.
War devil. A threat to the living. Evil incarnate.
Shit! You saw her. Advocatus Diaboli.
Advocatus Diaboli. A devil's advocate. A champion in the blood war between diabolical forces and demons.
You rolled high in history, so you just know that for some reason.
Apparently so.
I'm no stranger to the infernal. Better to slay a devil before
her. See, I'm smart. I know things.
Her name is Garlak, an archdevil soldier I swore on my good eye to kill. I tracked her through the hells to the Mindflayer ship, but the damned Illithids infected me before I could end her. She's out there now, preying on the innocent. I don't kill her, she'll leave behind nothing but a trail of corpses.
So if I say partner up, the he's not going to join the party because we're full.
Yeah, we can just send him to camp, though.
Okay.
And then from camp, we can, like, trade out different characters, depending on who you want with you.
Yeah, maybe. All right.
Just so you know, my first duty is Karlak. I'm oath-bound to go after her. But I won't deny this infection is bothersome.
I accept your invitation. You'll need to make room if you want to partner up, though. Still, when the time comes, call for the blade. I won't be long to answer. A splendid plan. We'll talk more there.
Yeah. I mean, that's always going to be an option with, like, characters you can have in your party, but as you can see with Lazel, you can also just... You know, kill them.
Still haven't gotten over that, huh?
I mean, it's kind of hard to get over when I'm wearing her clothes. Boring. Kind of a bit of a reminder. Out of the ordinary.
As you turn back, the child slips between the rocks.
Oh boy.
Help you a little bit at least.
Oh, but it's got, yeah. Intelligence.
You look the rocks over, but find no sign of a way through.
Damn. Oh well.
So this guy hitting the training dummy is pretty worth talking to.
Mm-hmm. Just let me climb on the crates.
Step, parry, strike, damn it! It's just not landing. Nothing but. Goblins in the wild, out for blood, and the druids in here looking to kick us out. Or worse. We need to be ready for a fight. But I'm useless with a sword.
Detect thoughts, barbarian. Don't waste good anger on your thoughts. Use it on the target.
Rage, you say? Step, brace, parry, swift guard! Still not landing.
You're not angry enough. Again!
That's actually hilarious. I've never seen that.
Bet you'll put it to good use. Don't let the druids hear you say that. They're itching for an excuse to get rid of us. But I'll keep at it. Thank you.
One last thing. Don't shout your moves like that.
Oh, yes. I'll bite my tongue when the time comes.
Right, leave.
Beautiful.
Good interaction.
Taught him how to use his anger. Just like you.
Got to yell louder. I can't hear you. Do it again.
Over in here. Something happening.
Right through that?
There's a wooden door there.
I feel like one of these days I'm gonna walk through a door and I'm just gonna explode. It's like something's happening in there. Step through the door. Shoot me. Your hands are shaking.
Put it down. She can't fight back.
That's the point. Get out of the way.
She didn't kill your brother, Arca. You're better than this.
Shoot before you lose your nerve, Tiefling. If you ever had it to begin with. Looks like the Absolute sent me a protector. You're gonna kill him too?
You, move!
Yeah. Okay, well, that was a easy success.
What in every hell is wrong with you? Damn you. Damn it.
Just love in the background. 0000000.
Gods, you're exhausting. Fine, then.
It's all right, Arca. Let's go.
Oh, you thieves are all boring. Even your cages are boring.
Sazza.
Why are you protecting me? Don't care, neither. It's too late to make friends, warg meat. My tribe's coming. They're gonna burn this pretty place for the glory of the Absolute and hang you by your guts. Goddess, we're burning her name across the face of the world, we are. The Absolute is gold from the sky, she is. The blessing in the storm and the storm itself.
You've caught my interest. Have any holy literature on you?
Maybe she sent you to help me. And you will, if you want to save your skin. And if the thief stick a few arrows in us on the way out of here, don't worry. Priestess Gut will patch us up. Got a whole lab set up. Cooks up potions that fix our lads, no matter how much of a beating they take. Could probably stick your head back on if someone was to chop it off. Mighty booyah. It's the truth. I swear on your mother's grave. Get me out of here, and I'll tell you where to find her. Deal?
Leave.
I'm gonna bite the heads off your kids, and your birdies, and your dogs.
Just walk away. It's fine.
Probably for the best that you didn't bust that goblin out of jail.
Yeah, I just wanted to see the interactions. It's like, nah, we're good.
Alright, both of these people here we're talking to.
God, this is boring. You saw you fighting those slimy bastards. Fancy a bowl? Best to fill your belly now while we still can.
Man, it's kind of making me hungry.
Look, it ain't much, but it might make all the difference.
It's called Shut Up and Eat.
The only way we'll make it to Baldur's Gate is to run, and run hard. If a gnoll catches your scent, you'll need every bit of strength. Trust me.
The target practice.
Gruel.
You got some gruel. There's also Auntie Ethel in that tent over there.
Tent? Oh.
The little, like, teepee-looking thing. Right over here, next to the gruel lady.
Oh, I thought over here you meant.
Oh, that guy's too. He's also another vendor. Any gear?
Just ask. My selection's pretty slim. I had to leave most of my equipment in Elturel.
Don't think I have any... What about to buy armor class? It's armor class, armor class. So, I can't wear armor, right? It just has to be clothing.
Mm-hmm.
Armor, light armor, medium armor. Yeah, nothing really here. Alright. Tent. Oh, here.
Yeah.
Auntie Ethel.
It isn't the talk of the camp. Thank goodness you came along when you... Oh. Your cheeks aren't nearly ruddy enough, Petal. Are you hurt? Cold? Feverish? Auntie Ethel will sort you out. I've lotions and potions galore.
Lotions and potions.
You take a sip of that, and you'll feel right as rain, sweetie.
Yeah, just...
As you down the potion, a comforting warmth spreads through you.
Hmm. I swear, you're still as peaky looking. Oh, I've seen it all. I once had a fella who'd been caught dabbling with a dryad. The wife was none too pleased.
Dabbling. That's like calling oil.
But worry not. I fixed him up, and depending on the lighting, he looks good as new.
I like that. Depending on the lighting.
I promise I've seen worse. What is it, Petal? What's wrong?
I feel like I should just be right and honest.
As you recount your adventure, Auntie Ethel nods along, her eyes wide.
You poor pet! My heart goes out to you, truly. I see no sign of a tentacle yet, but that could change in an instant. You need help. Serious help.
Damn, I thought she'd help.
I've ne'er a potion or lotion here that could do it, but... Yes, I may have something at home.
No.
I've collected some interesting bits and bobs over the years. You'll have to stop by my house just at the edge of the forest. Let me mark it on your map. I'll be heading back soon, so I can meet you there.
Now, seems legit.
Need anything? I have a few odds and ends for sale. Hey, bother.
Oh, dried pork sausage, yes.
I love how excited you were about that. He's got all kinds of potions and shit, and you're just like immediately looking at the sausage like... like, oh shit, that looks really good.
Gotta get me some of that sausage, dude. Okay. Literally just buying the sausage.
That's all you need, man.
Be careful on the road. I'd hate if something happened to you. Take care, Petal.
Okay.
Alright. Let's see. This dude over here, fourth combo. Aridin. The dude that
yeah,
it's the adventurer that was stuck at the gate.
Fearless goblin slayer, you sure you want to be seen with me? I ain't exactly popular with this lot. Half my crew are full of holes. Now I'm gonna take the blame for leading the goblins here and losing track of the bloody druid.
They chased us all the way from the ruins we were poking around in.
Aye, his name's Halsin. And if he's still alive, he'll be cursing the day he laid eyes on me. We've got a contract to track down some relic, and he wanted in on the job. Eyes lit up when he heard about it.
Didn't work out, though. Goblins got him when we were turning tail. He's either digging latrines or boiling in a cook pot by now. Job's all yours, if you got a death wish.
There's a wizard in Baldur's Gate that'll pay gobloads for a relic supposedly buried round these parts. But gold ain't any use if you're too cold to spend it.
If I knew that, I wouldn't be back here with half my crew gone. But look, if you're itching to meet Kellenvor, I won't stop you.
It's called the Night Song. Supposed to be hidden under the temple where the goblins jumped us.
I'd give you the map and wish you a happy funeral. But my mate Brian kept hold of it like his own todger. Goblins made short of the fat old chunk.
All I've got's the contract. It'll show you where we turn back, if you feel like dying. Don't thank me. I'll be well on my way to Baldur's Gate when you die.
The damn brood.
Yeah, dude's a bit of a dickhead.
Yeah.
All right.
He was trying to say,
you know, his friends died, he's angry.
How stupid are you?
So, yeah, let's go through this way. You can talk to the rat if you want.
The rat? There's a rat? Oh, back there.
You see it?
Oh, yeah, there.
Stay back,
It's the front one. I chipped it on the evil thing. In the box. Follow me, I'll show you.
God.
A lot of people will tell you that animal speak is, like, mandatory this game, and there's so much you miss out on about it.
But yeah.
Oh, garlic! Oh, yes!
I got my garlic.
Yeah, the rat went in there, but it's locked. And it's also considered a crime.
Really?
So, I don't know.
There's no other way in?
No? I can pick the door lock there if you want to go in there.
Poor rat. It said evil thing.
Yeah, people won't be happy if we do it.
It's fine, we can leave it. And plan to be
You aren't overwhelmed by curiosity of where the rat went?
Nah, I did find garlic.
Yeah. You can talk to this kid if you want, Mattis.
Garlic and potatoes. And a sausage. Like, that's a whole meal right there.
Pretty much.
Go on. Take this ring. It's lucky. Call it heads or tails.
Pocket the ring. Tails.
Tails it is. See? That's the kind of luck you get from one of my lucky rings. I've got more where that came from. Real cheap, too. Interested?
Seems like a scam.
Okay, fair. Let's go again. Heads or tails, call it. Heads it is. There. Happy?
Wait, so what do you mean? Is this ring's not free?
That's you just being like, alright, thanks for the ring, dumbass.
But does it give me... It's not a ring, like... We'll do it one more time.
Really? I mean... Fine. Heads or tails? We got tails! There. Happy? Mister, come on. Okay. Heads or tails? We got tails! There. Happy? Fine. Heads or tails? We got tails! Happy? Heads or tails? We got tails! There. Happy? You're killing me here, mister. You really are. Just take the ring, huh? Free sample. Now, you want to take a look at the other stuff I got? Or do you just want to go?
Oh, fuck. Examine the ring as a door.
The metal is coarse and riddled with imperfections.
It's just a ring, mister. I know it's... Now, please, please, buy something or go.
Oh man.
One sec.
What's that all you wanted me to do? Perception.
I mean,
failed.
I wanted you to have the option.
Oh my god, a butter bun. Perception.
You read
failed.
All the descriptions for his items, it's pretty funny too.
Resistance, infinite wishes. The glob of truce have studded with dead ants occupies the space where this ring stone once sat. Right, so they're fake rings. I mean, I think that's the thing, is like, I identified that pretty quickly.
Mm-hmm.
That was great.
Nothing caught your eye.
Nope.
You suddenly feel right. Something moving against your back and turn.
Pickpocketing little shit. Ooh. We want to say, ah, come on. Not enough.
Hey, enough. No, you got it. Oh, we got it. My guidance rolled a 4.
Nice. Plus 4.
Oh God!
Help! Really? Still ran? We can chase him into the hole. What do you mean can't use it right now?
It's because you're too big.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I'm a dwarf.
You can't fit.
How much smaller does it want me to be?
You can't fit, bro. You have to be like a halfling or a gnome or a child.
Okay, well.
I mean, dwarves are short, but they're pretty chunky. I mean, look at you.
I suppose. I am a bit on the stocky, thick side.
And I am a big man.
Why can't I use the ladder now?
I'm blocking it, my bad.
Now I'm too thick to use the ladder. Oh, shit. What the fuck? Okay.
Well, glad that happened. Yeah, I just head down there.
Do you get this thing where the screen shifts when a
cutscene
plays?
Yeah, it's a bit weird sometimes. Yeah. Get back!
Oh, let me through, Ragrishab, or I'll rip your damn throat out!
The hell?
Give him a chance. You, get back. Keep back. Force my hand and I'll show you its claws.
A moment, Giona.
What? Oh, I understand.
What did he say?
Apparently Korga wants to see you. Go ahead.
Okay,
so come back up here. These two guys talking to.
Lock.
We need to get Arabella out now.
You heard the guards. They're waiting on Korga to give word.
I'd sooner trek through the nine hells than trust that snake. Ugh.
Now. I don't know why, but my pants appear to be jiggling. Why?
Jiggling?
Jiggling. Like, look at the part beneath the bone that's hanging off my belt. Just watch that spot. Just watch that spot carefully. It jiggles.
It's blowing in the wind.
Well, it looks like my crotch is moving. That's what I'm getting at. Oh, shit.
Arabella tried to steal their idol. Druids lost their damn minds about it. They need it for their precious ritual.
Oh, it's all my fault. I told her I wished the wretched thing would just disappear, or better yet, explode.
Now Arabella's being judged by a bunch of druids who hate us. That's not right.
Okay.
I Should have tried parenting her.
Should have tried parenting her.
Brutal.
Well. Yeah, I mean. I don't know what to pick. It's like.
It's up to you how you want to go about these things, man.
Thieves deserve to be punished. Yeah, I'm gonna go with that one. Fucking didn't like that one.
I'll rush the guards. You sprint past. Alright,
you two, love. We'll find another way. I thought they were gonna do something. What?
So this bear and this man are both worth talking to.
Bosk.
Just a moment. This man is recording my story. I am far from home.
As the colorful man starts scribbling, the bear sneaks a quick look at the page. His brow furrows. Incomprehensible squiggles surround a crude sketch. A bear disemboweling a clutch of tieflings.
What the fuck?
You can talk to the guy now.
Oh. Volo.
Ah, my good friend. You were at the gates just now, no? When the goblins came? You saw them up close? A few questions, if you please. There's no overstating my interest.
Okay.
Glory. Now then. How would you describe that particular batch of goblins? Size, nature, distinguishing qualities.
You search your mind, but remember nothing. Apparently, about no history. Social order or behavior.
Give an exact description.
Goblins were of a rare, jam-colored hue and wielded magic blowguns. And the dragon they had marching in the rear, was it of the brass or silver variety?
Brass.
Mistook obvious silver dragon for brass.
This is like a question. Then you'll be the John Cleese bit.
Did the attackers rally to the absolute when they fell upon the gates? They did, didn't they? Oh, curious indeed. I've interrogated one, a captive in this very camp. She reports they've abandoned their god, Maglaviat, in favor of someone called the Absolute.
You saw her. Scandal. Called your tongue.
Never you mind. I'm on my way to their camp as we speak. I always knew my studies in Kukliak would come to some use. Why, goblins, obviously. But someone ought to chronicle these curious events. I'd heard the master of this place, a druid called Halsin, might be able to point me in the right direction. But he's been quite captured by them already. Ironic, really.
He's gonna wind up dead later, isn't he?
My friend, every story benefits from a dragon. Until we meet again.
Can't argue with that.
Hold on, let me fuck you with my headphones. Give me a second.
My grizzled friend.
Sign.
What can you tell me about this place?
I was gonna say it's probably worth taking an intermission anyway.
Yes, I see. And is that
assuming you're gonna be up for much longer? Assuming getting headphones on. What else have I got?
There we go. My headphones died. That was weird.
Yeah, that's okay. I was just saying, like, how long do you plan on being up?
Probably not for too much longer.
Okay.
I think we can, like, finish up some interactions in the Druid Grove, and then I'll just call it for the evening.
All right, cool. Yeah, because I was thinking of, like, taking an intermission soon, but we can, like, and just go towards that.
Yeah. You can talk to this bear.
I got stuck for a sec. It couldn't figure out how to path up this bear? Oh, tough it.
Yeah.
Oh, is this going to be what I think it is? Throw a fish next to the elevator.
Yeah, oh. Basically just worth getting him to move off the elevator because it's a like easier way to get to like down here from the entrance of the grove.
The camera. Whoa, jeez. Sometimes I end up inside objects.
Yeah, the camera's a bit janky sometimes. Come talk to Topaz.
I wish I had WASD movement.
Yeah, that'd be kind of nice sometimes.
Wait.
Resolving this peacefully will require more caution than you displayed in getting caught. With your ill-gotten gains discarded, the accusation fizzles away.
Okay, that's fine. I'm trying to walk away from it.
My bad. I can talk to Tusk if you want.
Tusk?
Just is the pig.
I thought you were Halsey.
The boar prances around, haunches clenching and unclenching impatiently.
Where's Halsey? Promise me a meat.
Oh, okay.
Anyways, so through here, this wooden door there.
Boar just wanted, okay.
I'd probably throw down an F5 too. It's good to just kind of like save intermittently.
No, just you're not just saying that like because the door is a bad door.
It's not necessarily a bad door.
Could be a bad
door. Potentially a bad door.
That's the kid.
This is madness, Korga. She's just a...
A what, Wrath? A thief? A poison? A threat? I will imprison the devil. And I will cast out every stranger. Girl. You mean parasite.
She eats our food, drinks our water, then steals our most holy idol in thanks.
Wrath, lock her up. She remains here. Until the rite is complete. And keep still, devil. Teela is restless.
Come, Korga. We took back the idol. Surely...
Do it.
Apparently. 19, A.
Let's go.
I... Very well. Teela, to me.
Sivits. Out, thief. It's a good name for a snake, honestly. Sivits.
It hurts.
Thank you, Korga. Master Halsin.
Wait, what? What hurts? Keep his name off your tongue. What? Lest Teela pierce it. What was that?
Hello.
What was that?
Talk to Shadowheart about it. See how she has the little exclamation mark over her head?
Little exclamation, no. Wait, oh, I've got to rotate the camera.
For Shadowheart, you don't see it?
Yeah, now I do. I have to rotate the camera. I thought you meant, like, the portraits. Not a good time.
Oh, okay. Only guy I can talk to her because I have control over here. Here, you can, I'll talk to her and you can listen in on the conversation.
Okay.
So next to my thing, you should see a little ear.
Yeah.
You're wondering why I was in pain before. It's just an old wound that hurts me from time to time. Nothing to be concerned about. It's nothing to do with the tadpoles, at least, in case your imagination is in danger of getting away from you. It's just something I have to live with.
Hmm.
Quite a lot, if I'm being honest.
This is a bit random.
It always passes quickly, so I can manage. Positive. You can trust me on that.
The outfit is making me laugh. Okay, well.
Well, yeah, I guess that's kind of a good point to call it for me.
Do we see the parents or no? It's just, that's it.
Yeah, you can go talk to the parents. You gotta go back to where they're at.
Okay.
Can do that as the last thing, I suppose.
Yeah, I think that's the last thing, is just like logically just wrap up that quest. Yeah.
They're back up where you first talked to them.
Yeah, it's just camera rotation, so it's like map orientation is.
Yeah.
You ever scare me like that again, and I'll feed you to a gnoll.
Mom, I'm fine. Stop it.
Oh boy.
Our little Hellion told us what happened. Thank you. Don't know what we'd do without her.
I saved your daughter, got any more me though, thanks. This could have ended more badly, keep her in line.
Yeah. I mean, thank you for helping me.
Stop.
I receive a locket.
Yep. That locket lets you cast Dancing Lights.
Dancing Lights? The fuck is Dancing Lights?
It's just like a light source.
I think I'd rather talk to the dead.
Yeah.
<that's, laughs> just be able to speak with everything. Animals, the dead.
Alright, well yeah, you can put down
a
hard save if you want.
Oh, how do you hard save? Is this escape and then save?
Yeah.
Oh my god, it's sinking.
Like, the quick saves are pretty much good enough, but, you know, it's nice to have backups on your backups.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Hold on. Ugh, it's doing the sync thing. Well, I guess I'll do, like, the YouTube outro thing.
Sounds good.
Yeah, I mean, if you're watching later on YouTube, thanks for sticking around to the end. Hope you enjoyed this initial look at Baldur's Gate and didn't scream internally too much when I jumped into the lake, amongst other things. But yeah, if you want to support the channel, just remember algorithm button pressing stuff, whatever I usually say. And I'm sure two other videos have popped up on your screen if you want to watch me do other stuff. But till next time, bye YouTube.